All right. Good afternoon, everyone. Please allow me to welcome you all for today's program. I mean, on behalf of our college, Bidhanchandra College, I'd like to welcome you all for this program, today's program, which is the induction of the Google Workshop for Education in Bidhanchandra College. And we have, as speaker today, we have Dr. Vinay M. He's a Google professional. He's a trainer from the Google. And we also have Professor Samunto, who will also probably take a few questions, but it's mainly Dr. Vinay who has been helping us in developing this module. I'll just give a very brief idea about what we intend to do here. The Google Workspace for Education is a cloud-based productivity suite, and now we have it. It's basically designed for the educational institute to collaborate, streamline instructions, and allowing educators to focus more in the education part of the thing in a smarter way. Now, we have the Google Workspace in the Bidhanchandra under the domain of the Bidhanchandra College. So all of your email address has been already sent to you. We will hope that you will log into you today or tomorrow and start using it heavily in all your classes. This will eventually help us build a more coherent way of educating the students, keeping the records, which is also important for NAC and other accreditations. And I'm very happy to inform you all that Bidhanchandra College is probably the only one, or at least in a very few institutes in West Bengal, which has enabled the Google Workspace for Education for now, for all faculty, students, and staffs. So as we go through the training, which I will be passing to Professor Vinay, let me also thank our principal, sir, for this mammoth encouragement all through while we're working on these kind of tools, and particularly this team which has helped develop this one. I mean, like my colleagues Ajay, and definitely Biswajit Da, Professor Gautam Mukherjee, and Soumen sir, Sujit sir, all of them. I'd like to thank them personally. And I will request Professor Vinay to actually get started with today's program. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome everyone. First of all, I think I would like to say thank you for taking an initiative on implementing certain things into your college. There are many things which we have seen the changes in an education forms. What we have seen in the last two decades has drastically shifted in last 1 year. Whatever we did, I think, whatever we planned, whatever we wanted to do is all side mode. And then whatever was required for us, we started doing on certain things which was more important as part of our education systems. Nobody would have predicted that this much fast or this way we will change our education part, or maybe the way in which we would like to handle our classes in the way it happened in last 1 year. Now also it has not stopped. We were thinking that this year, at least last year gone, and then this year we will be able to go online to offline, and then we come back and then do that. But the situation right now is not allowing us to do so. We are still in the moment of where this can help us in, or maybe after the COVID started in the last year, January onwards maybe, or maybe in the month of lockdown started March onwards, people started thinking about how do we go ahead in regular mode to an online mode, or technology into the classrooms, or digital platform into my classroom is what the teacher's mind started. Somehow, hook or crook method, people started utilizing this. They understood like this is what is required, and a lot of tools have been done at all. As a part of our responsibility through a Google program, we have started working with many colleges and many universities and institutes, including a schools to an university level, helping them to bring your classrooms into a more sophisticated way in a digital platform without much affecting your regular mode as it is. But still, you will be able to communicate with your students, work with your students, not only in this right now situation, but start from this situation, but it can go ahead with even when you come back to your regular mode of online class to offline class, hybrid class, but still you should have certain things which can help. We know that it is not like an overnight situation where we can change our college system or education system into a regular mode to an fantastic online mode, like in Western style. We cannot change it immediately. As you know, that Indian system, Indian education system, our colleges, our students are not easy to transform them. There are many students who may not be reaching with mobile phones. They are not with the internet. They are not with the computer systems. But still, we have to ensure that everyone reaches, or we are able to reach everyone and to pass our educations to them. Keeping that in mind, this has been started. This is not today's what we are discussing. This is there from last 15 years in the market, but people have not realized, they have not used it. We have used it for 15 years. I'm more experienced with this usage of this itself in the last 15 years. And we are quite successful in that completely. During this was not a new for us because we were using a technology always. But I think hopefully after this session, it will definitely give you a lot of confidence and advantages with what are all the things available by collaborating with Google Workspace with your institute. What do you, what it is exactly, what it gives you, and how can you utilize this in your regular mode to maintain all your documents, communication, collaborations to endless possibilities with this. That's what we will, I would like to show it today, and we'll try to discuss on this. Now, to make sure that it is easy, I will just give me 1 second. I'll share my screen so that you can see this. You can see. Just give me a second. I'm making some settings and just checking. It's okay. I'll show my full screen because I need to shift between windows sometimes, showing your demo as well as the other options. Hopefully it will be full now. So I'll keep this in the down somewhere. Presentation screen comes, yes. Now, Google is not just a search engine anymore, which we have understood in the last few decades itself. Google started as a company called as Google Search Engine. Slowly, they have enhanced into a lot of new softwares, applications, development, and for much more better works, they have started as a company. Now, it is a global work, mainly for an information gathering and then making it available to everyone. With that aim, they started. One part of the Google work is referred as Google for Education. Earlier, we had a part of this. It was called as Google for Education program. And the whole set of program, what you see right now, is called as G Suite Parallel. Last few months back, when this, after the pandemic situations, they have also updated a lot. New things have been introduced. With that, they have brought something new. That is, were renamed or rebranded. Now it is called as Google for Education into a Google Workspace for Education. Now, what is this? This is a one part of Google possibilities of a lot of implementations. One part of that, they work towards educations. Why it education? It's not good to train your students after they pass out degree and then go to the job, and that training over there is not a good idea. Training your students during the education system itself will make sure that they're ready for the work in the office. That's a major advantage why they brought into the system. Now, what this is fully, why this came into picture, because see, we have to definitely work towards our education system. But people think, oh, bring the technology, it will change everything. Please note that that is not the magic what we are going to do everything every time. As an educator, as a teacher, it is our responsibility to do ensure that we do the best in the part what we do. Technology, single, only one part cannot improve your educations. Bringing a new software, bringing a new tool, or making everyone with new tool, new software, brand name may not give you complete improvement. But these tools can definitely make your powerful part of your solutions, what you do it in your classrooms, is always possible. That's where we consider teaching and learning part is improvement is possible with this kind of things where you bring the technologies into them. That's what said by Sundar Pichai, CEO of Google. That's what exactly followed by Google Education Program. Now it is under Google Workspace. Now, before we start looking at that, what exactly do you get with this? It's just already, as Sir Al-Swamit was also mentioning, where you will get an email with your college name as the one which is for official communications. But don't worry, don't look at the tools right now. First, look at that. What do you get? Why do you need all this? What do you get from this? Then one by one, I will show you all that what you get and how it can be effectively used as well. This Google for Workspace Education is mainly for improving the educational systems with three aspects mainly. One is simple. lot of people, you may have questions in your mind that, oh, from Saturday afternoon, somebody is talking about a Google tools, this and that. You might be familiar with few of this already. Few of the things may be new, or maybe you would use your personal email to do a lot of facilities like this. Still, with the official one is completely, you will get more features and more advantages. First option is that this whole program is very simple. And anybody who knows how to use a mobile phone, how to use a simple, even if you don't know how to use a laptop also, it's fine, but you'll be able to use all the tools of these Googles are as simple as that. That's why it's called as very simple. It is flexible. It's according to your institute. Say you may have certain rules, regulations, or your methodologies, deanery level, maybe different groups of students, maybe postgraduate, undergraduate, multiple things, research. You can adjust accordingly. Fine-tune the entire tools, maybe fit enough to work according to you is possible, where that is a flexible. And next people will ask, sir, we are starting using something called as Google Workspace. How secure is this? These are most three common things which everybody asks when they start using this. I have made at least around 70 to 80 colleges in last 1 year to use this across India. I have implemented and have trained them, made them to work. But what is they have done is, why they liked all this is because of three. It's very, very simple. You don't need to worry about too many things. We are ready to give you a lot of trainings wherever, where and whenever it's necessary. We will provide it. Flexible, according to your requirements, it can change fast, slow, adjustments, other things are possible. It's completely secured because nobody else can hack this. And it is on a HTTPS with 128-bit encrypted data. Even whatever you save it, even in the cloud, it is completely secure. Unless you share your credentials to somebody else, like your username and password, nobody can even touch your files. It's as much secured as this, including your admin cannot do anything with your file. They can close your account, but they can't do anything with the file. That security that will help you to do on this. Then, this is a complete set of tools. Somebody's mic is on. If you don't mind,
please. Hello. Kajolda, please mute yourself. Kajolda, please mute yourself. Kajolda, Kajol Goswami.
Okay, fine.
Yes, okay.
Four things where, when you start using this, we are looking at perspective of two things. One, teaching and learning both, as well as it may be some later, you can also use it for an administrative purpose. A lot of data can be collected and analytics can be done on this. First, four major things, what the tools you see today is all majorly for enhancing your class instructions. There is a lot easy to use tools are available, better for your collaboration and connection with your students and your colleagues and departments and administrative staffs. That's why it's an enhancement of your classroom instructions. Boosting your productivity. It saves a lot of time for us. Instead of doing a lot more work with multiple systems and multiple softwares and multiple methods, make it into a single one. It's more easy for creating any kind of a files, structures, or maybe data, organizing it in better format, and grading is in the same place possible. That means you announce, you collect the data assignments, and do the whole work inside and online is possible with this. That's where it boosts your productivity. Time is increased more easily. You can finish it fast. Elevate your student works. Best work with the simple tools, and may your student also should feel comfortable, and they should also get like, yeah, this tool helps me, and this is what we would like to do, can be done on this. And complete your school or college or university or institute data is completely protected. Do not worry about the feature with like my data is lost, somebody has taken it. No, there is no third party here. There is nobody else. Why? Because these things you should know in advance before you use your Google Workspace for Education. As a teacher, you are the one who takes this to your students. As an administrative staff, they have done already their part and we collaborated and it entire things comes to you and you are bringing this into your students now. You are the one. As a teacher, you are using, bringing it to the students and connecting with them. Do not worry. Always be confident that the data is always protected and complete control is there with us. No third party can enter and they can't take any data, including email, phone number, data. Nothing will go out from here. It's fully secure. Who uses this as of right now? This is more than 170 million students are using across the world and they're all happy. They don't say that, say this just because it is one tool, new tool, we are using it. No, this is not like that. This is from the beginning of your classroom till the end of your assessment. complete examination till that time, all tools are provided. That's why it is very good and people are happy and they're using it. This whole programs gives you, this is the advantages. One, first thing you should know that this, what right now the enabled for your institute is completely a free version and ad-free. Ad-free is nothing but there is no advertisement, no spam, no extra email. Somebody is sending an advertisement like WhatsApp. You would have seen that many advertisement comes, many good morning comes, many photos comes, many unwanted forward is too many nowadays. But this Google for Work, Google Workspace for you is completely advertisement free. No spam will appear at any point of time. This is completely free. Auto filtering will happen. It's completely reliable and it is secure. It is available all the time, 24/7. Server downtime is calculated as 99.99999%. It's uptime. That means the chances of 0.801 is the chances of maybe server down. Otherwise, always it is up and it works. So for all tools, what we are going to see today, you don't need to worry about, sir, should I remember username, passwords? No. For all tools, one username. For all tools, one password. So what we have given you an email address, as of now, I think it would have been communicated to you. Those emails will be the one which will help you to use all the tools in one place. If you use email officially, that's why try to learn that, practice it so that it will be easy for you. Sir, we have already a personal emails. We may be using that. That was a day over for your personal purpose. But now onwards, for all official purpose, for your all college communications, your institute communications, from institute side to you, from your side to institute, from your side to student and student side to you, use only official email. That will be a record for you. For anything you have announced, for anything you receive it, it will be a record. Maybe for UGC, NAC or anything, it will help you in all the work. One, what ICT you have implemented. You can say that Google Workspace for Education is completely there. How do you communicate? You will get it. How do you organize? You have a tool. How do you share everything? How do you work with them? For everything, we have it. But it's in one place, organized way. That's why it is in one login. You don't need to work alone. You can work with your colleague. You can work with your department. You can work with other departments. You can work with maybe physics can work with electronics. Biology can work with sociology. Sociology can work with psychology. Psychology can work with computer science. Possible. You can make any purple, even students, faculty, and administrative. Anybody can work together simultaneously, any number. Sir, 5,000 people can work in a single document, possible. That means 1 to 5,000 people is okay. But we don't expect 5,000 people to work in a single document. But we expect like 5 to 10 people can work. Therefore, some work, maybe a document preparation for a presentations, you can do collaboratively. For all types of works, you can do it. And all these things, what we discussed today, is available with you. That means what is available under Google Workspace is available in, works in all devices. So you need not worry, sir, I have an iPhone, sir, I have a small Android device, sir, I have a monitor, I have a laptop, I have a computer, I have a tab. It's okay. Any device is okay. What you need is only internet connections. If you have a proper good internet connection, it works more smoother. Normal 2G also, if you have it, it works. Maybe a little slow, but it still works. It is fine. Fantastically, it will not eat much more data from your side at all. No, it will take much lesser compared to all other software and it works. Keep this. These are all the things is bundled together and it's available for you when you start using each one. But this one is completely in two. Earlier, it was only one format. The whole software was available. Now they made it into four different softwares. As a general knowledge or for just for your information, I'm specifying this. You need not worry about this slide. Because there are four, earlier it was only called as Google for Education. Now they divided that into Google for Workspace in four formats. One, Education Fundamentals, Education Standard, Teaching and Learning Upgrade, and Education Plus. What do you mean by this? First version, which is like Education, which is Fundamentals, is completely available for free. That's the first part. Remaining all three is chargeable. Now what are we using right now is free. Every qualifying institute will get this for free for lifelong. Need not to worry about that. But all other things we need to pay for as the demand increases or we need more things about this insights. I want to know more, my detailed report I want, or I want more people to see live. All that when we wanted it, features, specialized features whenever we need it, we need to go for this. It starts from $3 per student per year to $5 per student per year. It goes on. This is how the whole program has been set up by them. Now, while working with this, what do we get in this? This is what your curiosity will be. Fine, sir, Google for Workspace is fine. What do we get? That's why I said some of you might have already seen this. Some of you have already worked. Some of you may be familiar with this. Maybe some of you are not it and they are just new to this. All different combination of people may be together in this. These are all just the icons. It start for a different purpose. Why are they giving all different tools for all these? Purpose is also different. What is the necessity for that? We need to start using this. I will show each one in details so that you will get a glimpse. I know that, see, within given 1 hour, 2 hours, whole thing cannot be. That's why it's called as an induction or maybe orientation programs, where you get a familiarity of all these things as a glimpse. Now, after some time, maybe I request you to note down if required. Anyway, the whole session is recorded. PPTs will be shared with you. Then later you'll be able to go through that and have an idea about what tools we are getting with this, my email, and what is the, my purpose of requirement. Use those tools and utilize it. Once you use, then you may have certain questions will come into your mind and then come back and ask, get clarified, start using it again. We did the same thing. Starting when it was released, we did not know that what is the purpose of these tools. But this, when you start using it, you'll become more familiar. You may have doubts, but once it clarifies, you'll become more proficient or a better user of all these tools, and that enhances your work. Now, I'm considering that as a teacher with our experience as well as a Google specification, what we have to train you. They gives you list of things what I'm supposed to train everybody across India. According to that, some few things have been listed here which can help you to do this. These, there are some more things. Now, apart from this, additionally, there are some more tools which will be useful for different purpose has been available. It's completely for collaborative works, listed, and it is ready to use. We will see all that, you have to use it. It will be definitely useful for all us in our daily work, which we do with teaching and learning. I think, just give me a second. I'm not sure whether I saved it here or not. Where did I save? First part, what is the need of Gmail? What do we do with as a first part of your teaching learning? It is as a teacher availability requirement for us that we need to communicate with our students. First, maybe with your colleague, maybe with your administrator, head of the department, coordinator, then your administrator staff or different departments. You have to communicate with each other is the first major requirement for all of us. That is why they have provided that. This is one of the tools which comes along with the workspace, which I also always prefer that. Get familiarity with this. This will solve most of your requirements with only one email. What is that? So it's a Gmail, which is a Google mailing service available as a cloud platform with the Google Workspace. No installation required. There is no download required for any of the things which I'm showing it. It's all in the cloud space. Cloud means it works in another server, in another computer, somewhere kept it in another place, which is invisible to us, but we are connecting to that using computer and internet. Computer for our interface, internet is for connecting between that. Once you get this kind of a things, it becomes more easy for you to work with all these tools. So you don't need to download, you don't need to wait. Even in mobiles, we have to download a lot of things, but in this case, no download. Use only one email address to log in, and then you can work. Sir, how do we log into our email? You just type gmail.com also. If you type it, automatically it becomes a gmail.in, and then it allows, ask you to open your username and password. Whichever we have provided, you can just use a full username and password. It works. Once you get familiar with that using, it becomes more easy for all of this. Now, what does this provides for us? It's similar looks what is there here I'm showing you. I will show with a real example as well. What are the additional things you get than our regular Gmail? See, most of you may have a Gmail address, which is your personal email. For me, it is like vinay@gmail.com is my personal. My official one is with college will be a different one, which can be used. Similarly for you, there will be two. One, your personal Gmail, which you use it for your bank, your personal, your family, your friend, your with son, daughter, with maybe your spouse, maybe with whoever it is, your personally, when you're communicating with them all is your that email. Do not use your university institute email for all those purpose like banking or for social media, no. You may have Instagram account, you may have a Facebook account. Those things should be used with your personal email, not with official email. So there should be a very good difference between your official email as well as your personal email. Keep the personal email. Use always official email. What does this gives you? One is basically for communication. You can collaborate with your friend, chat kind of a things. You can chat with them as a friend. or email address, whomever you have it, you can chat with them. And you can also have a lot of options with like meeting. Immediately, you would like to start a video meeting with somebody. Just I want to see your face and want to talk it. If you open a Gmail, clicking one button can open a video conferencing with your friend is possible. It's 100% spam free. That means there is nobody who want to send you an advertisement or extra things which is not belongs to your institute will not come to this email. And for every class, whichever it is. Now, if your emails are all perfect with that, we will be creating an option for all of your students as well as your class groups. So for every class groups, there will be an email. For example, department level, we have already created. You will have another group. Say if you belongs to a computer science department, all faculties will be grouped together and one email will be created, like faculty.cs, faculty.computerscience will be one group. You can send an email. That's called group email. It's not like everyone will have another email. No. You're all made as a group. If you belong to electronics department, if you belong to commerce, arts, anyone, each department will be grouped together. All faculties will be grouped together and they will be able to communicate with each other in one single email. Say, I want to communicate to all of you. That means 30 more people are there, 40 people are there. I would like to send, I can't send 40 emails. I will send only one email, but it will reach to all 40. See, how cool is it when you're 60 students and in a class? And you would like to communicate to all 60. You don't need to send 60 email addresses and send it. No, you don't need to copy paste all email address. You have to send only one. For example, if it is a BCom first year, say assume that the group email ID which we create will be like one BCom first semester, like one BCom A is A section at your college name .in.org will appear. So if you want to send an email, the group email address, you should remember and send it. That's it. You're a part of that. Automatically, it is easy for you, we to add you to a group and remove in the group, and then you can communicate with that. Your administrators will take care of doing that work, but it is easy. And a lot of plugins are available, like you have apps in your phone. Most of us, we use apps. And every day we use different apps. Even now recently, Arogya Setu you would have used for knowing that what is the status nearby me. And now for a vaccine, we are using a Covin. There is another app, or even inside Arogya Setu also you can do. Like that, every apps will come for a situation based. Here, like a calendar, Google Keep, Task, and other things, it automatically available. We will be able to enable as a user, you can do all these things. If you look at this email, I'm just showing you, this is where, which is a sample email window, which looks, this is my email address, which I'm using it. You will also be getting, you already would have got the email. When you open it, this is how it looks like. And color-wise, you don't worry. I have just changed some cartoon would have been appearing on the back end it is, but it may be in a white color look. It will appear on your standard size. What is the major advantage with this email? One is easy for you just to have a communication purpose. This is used. From your side to communicate with somebody else, from there to your side, you have to send to somebody. All that is appears over here. Grouping, other things, all are possible, which I'm trying to show with this. Now, on the left side, you could see that these are all the four major things which appears over here. I may have too many emails which are my emails. Too many things are there, I have to replay. Number will show here. If you get a new email, number will appear. This is all related to mail. Four things you can do in email itself. Remember, that's a major advantage for us, right? The mail you can do, you can chat with a friend, you can have rooms now. Earlier it was not there, now it is enabled for all of us. You will get even a room. So that means group of people can become a room, one room for all of us to discuss on project one. And HODs can discuss on another room where they want to implement when is the class starting next. Maybe the collaboration, strategic plan, other things they can work with this. That way this will help them a lot works. This is where you could see a meet. There are four: mail, chat, rooms, and meet. Meet is mainly for your video conferencing. I can show you like this. See, right now I want to start one Google Meet. Later I'll come back how to start that. This is where you can use, click one button and you can start. Easy. Room, you like to start a new room, you can do with this click on plus. Already existing rooms, you can just click and do it. Possible. Chat with somebody, click here. See, these are all the people, my own colleagues. I can make them work with them easily. One click, I can chat with them. Possible. Mails, all my emails will have certain things where your inbox comes in. You can even, there are advantages like snoozing, time moving, and then you can also make it for available for somebody else. See, now I'll show you. There's one email has come to me from someone. Say there is one email which says there is some exam has to be conducted for this fellow. Now I don't have time to reply for this. I can reply this to this email after some time maybe, but maybe this email I may forget. So let the email remind me again after sometimes. There's something called a snooze. See, when I move here, snooze, it shows me that it will remind me later today at 6 p.m. That means I don't want to reply right now. Let it come back. This email will remind me back again on 6 p.m. today or tomorrow or next week or sometime later. Based on my availability, I'll just do. So I'm just doing this later today at 6 p.m. This email will see it's gone. Email will come back to me again at 6 p.m. today and tells me, oh, this you have not replied. So there is a lot of things which are available here, which you could see how well it could be arranged. These are only glimpses I'm showing you. This Gmail itself will take 2 days to make everyone to understand. Huge tools are there. If I select something, you could see here how many things are there here. Lot of things. I can label them and I can work. For example, all my placements, I'll just show you. Just want to make sure that all the placement which appears will be in one group. See, there's a label. I've just made placement 2015. 2015 placement details I can get in one click. It's as simple, as easy. I'll be able to do something called as labeling. Every email comes, I can label it and it can be made colorful as well. So selecting an email, whichever has appeared, one option appears on top called labels. Clicking on that will allow you to already existing one you can use or create a new one. This is from attendance 2021 something. Okay, create. You can see one tag will add here. See, attendance 2021 will also be available here. I will just show you when it comes here. Yes, I can make sure that this has got some good color and it's easy. Now, by looking at the whole system, you don't need to search, scroll, do everything on this. It is just one click. You'll be able to find out that where is this attendance. See, so many mails, but you can find one. So that is the advantage of started using these tools. Much easy, much faster, and one click and compose. So writing an email, see, my auto addressing will also appear on this. Two address, auto type, subject, and send it. And sir, do I need to send this email right now? Not necessary. Say you would have written here. Just show you. Okay, this is for somebody. Say Samantha, sir, only I will try to send. Okay, test email. And this email is based on time. Okay, something I've written here. Thank you. Everything is over. Say some email information I've written here. I want to send this email at evening 4 o'clock today, not now. So if I click send, it will go immediately. So if you want to do something, there is another option called as send option. So you can see schedule send. I don't have to send it right now. I can send it on a schedule. Say tomorrow morning it can send. Day after tomorrow, maybe tomorrow after Monday, or you can pick your own date and time. Say today itself, let it go at around 4 p.m. Just schedule send. It is gone. It will not reach to that person unless it is 4 o'clock. At sharp 4 o'clock, the mail will go to them. So there, like this. This is just a glimpse for you. There are 200 features available inside one single Gmail, which will help you to understand that what best you can do it in for communication. And you want to, you're sending some question paper to someone. You are sending some other details to another person. Then you can do something called as like schedule send only. And another option is there called as secure sending with confidential mode, like OTP based. If I'm sending it to you, you have to enter the OTP from your phone, then only you can open my email. I can do that. If you don't open it in within 1 hour or maybe within 1 day, I will close this so that you can never access my email. I can do all that. That's called confidential mode, which is available. We can utilize this. Like this is, I'm just showing you one simple glimpse how an email can do. Within an email itself, I have more options. Like right side, you could see there are so many tools which are available. These are all called plugins. Additionally, as an administrator, we will give it to all of you. You don't need to worry much, and all these will appear to your email directly. Right now, at the beginning, it may not come. After 1 or 2 days, all enabled. Within 24 hours, if we get update, we are giving you all. So you have to just log in, utilize all these, start communicating, work with you. The basic settings, whatever you do, is available on the top settings. First time when you open, do not worry about all this. Just start using it. When you know that, the best ones, you can make it colorful. It will look like this one. Could see there. Theme which is available on this. You can see my whole email has changed now to white color now. It can be a colorful background. it can change into some other thing. See, now dark color, I can, according to your requirements, you can do comfortable movement, customizing, all is available. You have more plenty settings. That's why it requires another few days itself to learn all much more. This is enough to understand what we talked about is called Gmail. Gmail is one of the best way in which the communication starts with everyone. Communicate, collaborate, call the people with a video chatting or regular chatting, or send them, create a room and make the group of people for a project and work with them. It's no need to worry about any other extra things. It's all spam free and 100% genuine. Good option to communicate with everyone. Now, first part is that when you start using a Google Workspace, you should all have one email address. That's the first point entry towards this. To use all these tools, you need email. What email do is not just logging in. It is allowing to communicate, send an email, mark it, or maybe group it, you download it, you secure it, you schedule it, is all possible. So you can do with one simple email. Now, once the Gmail is familiar with you, you need to start using the next part. One by one, you can use it. What's the next tool which appears along with this is majorly organizing yourself. When is your next meeting? Will you be able to remember all the meetings? Maybe there are 13 meetings in the next Monday to Friday. Can you remember? How many classes will you remember? How many meetings you will remember? How many submissions you will remember? NAC or supporting documents, this document, that one, research papers. We are doing as a teachers a lot good jobs, but we don't remember that. It has to write down somewhere in your diary or maybe in other things we will do it. To make it more systematic way, in an automated way, there is a provision called as calendar. The basic advantage, it is well organized. And it is like your teacher, one who invites, in case if I want to call a meeting, I don't need to send an email to you. I don't need to personally send an email. I can go to a calendar. I will show you how it is. Go to a calendar, just click on a date and time, specify that whom you want to invite a meeting, just click OK. Automatic invitation will be sent to everyone. They can accept the invitation, they can cancel it, they can directly come to my meeting, and all in one click. So that makes our work more simple, organized, arranged, collaborated. Work happens in single calendar. Now for your class as well. When is your next class? Are you calling a class online? If you are trying to do an online class, you don't need to invite your students every day, every time. One time only you have to do, repeat it, click, click, two clicks, it should be able to work. Instead of wasting your 10 minutes of time, you can do 2 minutes of job using this. That's where calendar is most popularly used among all of us. How does it look like? This is a sample. I kept the screenshot because in case my browser does not work, I will try to show it over here. Now this demo is available so that I'll show you directly. Purpose, it's a second tool under the Google Workspace for Education, which is a very much necessary for all of us. When we start communicating, I should know that when to do, what to do, how to do, where is the meeting, when is the meeting. At least for my organizing, we keep all our to-do list, sticky notes. Similar to that, this is much better than that. Majorly, it is organizing, scheduling is possible. The scheduling is nothing but tomorrow, if there's a meeting at 10 o'clock, I can schedule it in such a way that before 10 o'clock, 15 minutes before, 10 minutes before, a reminder will come to me as a notification in my phone, as an email notification in my email, is easy to get it. The notification advantage is that most of us, we use phone. So in the phone itself, when as a like a WhatsApp notification or Facebook notification, if one more calendar notification comes and tells you that there is a meeting at 10, 15 minutes before, you will get alert, you'll get ready and we are organized. So automatically time waste will not happen and then we are ready to go ahead. Third, you can invite anybody. Even though you're inviting outside person, outside from your institute, you can invite it without a much hassle, secure. And who has to do it and who has to come into this and can they share my invite to somebody else can also be controlled. Sir, it is not just the organizing a to-do list over here. I want to have video conferencing with someone else. Can I add? Of course, you can do with that calendar. You will all get an, earlier it was SMS notification. Now because of the TRAI rules, no SMS notification, only mobile phone notification or in the system notification will appear on this. Now, how do we access this? There are multiple ways to access your calendars in much easiest way. You can go to a new browser window. You can type here as calendar.google.com is one way. Please do remember, I'm showing you direct method as well as the other indirect methods where we'll be able to work in this. Just give me a second, I'll use another one. How do we use this? Calendar.google.com is one way, which is most direct method to open any software. Email, gmail.com, you enter, you'll get that. If you are able to get this one, this you will be able to get it on this part. That's where it works. Now, what is our other methods to open on your email? That's why I said email is important. When you open email, on the right side top, you could see that there is a sixth line or a 9-dot boxes are there, which is one circular, which is called as Google Apps. Whatever we get in Google for Workspace is all listed over here in this box. If I click this, you'll be able to see this, including My Account, Google Search, Gmail, Calendar, Drive, Docs, Sheets, Slides, Site, Groups, Contacts, My Business, Chat, Meet, Currents, and goes on. YouTube, Photos, Forms, your Cloud, Podcast, Classrooms, everything. See, there are plenty. Still more are there, which we can add it into this. Right now, basic one, which all your apps, which you would like to use it in your regular day as a classroom purpose, as teacher, is all available in this. Here itself, you can go to this calendar. After this Gmail, just go to calendar. It's the same thing will open. Or directly go to calendar.google.com, you get the same thing. Here you'll be able to get this. This is where the My Calendars looks like. The previous one might look much a month before. You can, according to your requirements, you can arrange all these things. Let me just try to show that when it was good, that for how we were working on. See, if you look at this as weekly, this is how the colorful things, what you look here is how it will be. See, whichever is done, whichever is not done, as per your requirements, you will be able to add, arrange, and then schedule, organize is possible in a calendar. You have to use this. Don't think that, sir, I have my own diary, I have my own sheet, I have my own sticky notes. Maybe it is there, fine, correct, you are familiar with that. Now onwards, for a few days you start using this, you will become more familiar, you will never use anything. No more papers, no more extra works, and you may lose it, but here you will not. It's an added advantage. Few more things are there. One, at any point of time you feel that, say for example, I'll say month, I will try to show you. May, right, okay, may let it come with the current week. Current month, I will try. Okay, this is the today's one. After all, it is like this, which is working on this. Now, today, at maybe sometime later, I would like to have an appointment with somebody, say at 5 o'clock. You can just tap it here. See the calendar, how it looks like. Left side, the full month is coming. Below, there are calendars which are available. You can create as many calendars you want, but preferably at the beginning, do not create calendars. Don't worry about creating calendar. Already calendar exists, first use this. Later you'll be able to create more, which will be useful for us to work on. So here you can create at the specific time. See, this is where on the date, this is left side is on the time. You click where, when you would like to have a meeting. Click on this. This is just a scheduler. This is just like your regular diary calendar, what we used to write earlier, but it is online now. So here is, say, meeting with Amit sir. Here, like something like this. And advantages are there here. Now, what time you are trying to give this? On specific appointment times or generally an event at all? It's fine. On a Saturday, May 15th, 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. If there is a change, click and make a change here. Not today. Okay, tomorrow we would like to have. You can change the date. It automatically gets shifts and it works. One. Second, below there is, if there is a repetition of this meeting every day, daily, on every Sunday, every Monday to Sunday, or annually, or every weekdays based on that, or you can have your own custom and specific days only. You have all options. Please do remember, this helps a lot. If you're taking a class and you would like to repeat the class for every day, you have an option. Say monthly, third Sunday, or weekly on Sundays, annually on 16th, whichever is comfortable, or daily, you can make. Daily, 3 to 4, there's a class. Daily, there's a meeting, something like that, you will be able to handle. So that is what exactly this allows us. Then, is it only for you meeting? No, along with me, somebody else is there, right? Who is that person? He's my guest who is coming with me for a meeting. Here, there is a add guest option. You can click here and add a person. If nobody, no, sir, this is not for somebody. It is not like a meeting option. This is just a reminder for me. Both option I'll show you. If it is a meeting, you can type the heading. Or this is just like submit the document to library. Is another option. So I just don't need anything. I just, tomorrow 5 to 6, I have to submit the document to library and just click on save. My job is done. You could see here, submit document to library is done. This is for just for a reminder. It just comes at that moment. It will just tell you once notification saying that to submit this, over. There is other ways to do it where I am just showing you where one second, either in a full detail, just tap once and you can see the details. Now I want to add a meeting now. So meeting with Dr. Amit, something like this. Then I can add here guest. I need to specify the address here. Say that there is one email I'm just adding here. That means the whom I would like to invite here is already added here as guest for me. So what is the guest permissions? What the guest can do over here? Can they modify? Can they invite somebody else? Can they see who are all coming into this? I have an option to switch on, switch off. I have switched off. They can't do anything in this. A guest can come. They can only do visit and we can talk each other. But other than that, nothing. What is the advantage with this is whenever you switch on all this, the same person whom you're adding will also get an email and we'll be able to communicate each other. And then at the same time, we'll get a notifications as well. Now, this is the basic informations which are available here, which can be done. More detail if you wanted, you have an option called as more options. Just click once and see. For the same meeting, specify the date and time. Below you specify here with whom you are trying to do with that, adding a guest over here. See, adding guest will give me another option called as this one. See here. When you add guest, automatically it will add. If it is not, you can add something like this. Add Google Meet video conferencing. Just tap once. It will add automatically Google Meet as well, and link is also generated. So that automatically the person is invited, and he is a part of my meeting and we work. So when should be the notification or reminder? Here, see, notification 15 minutes before. Before starting the meeting, 15 minutes before, it will send a notification to everyone who is there in the meeting. I can add 100 people here, 200 people, but everyone can come here and we will have a interaction just before joining. 15 minutes, one notification will go down. Sir, I want one more 30 minutes before, and or I want 5 minutes before one, and see, 5 minutes before, 30 minutes before one, 15 minutes before one, and 5 minutes before one, notification will go to them just for ensure that they will come and join. Somebody is registered for a course, you can do like that. Color can be done according to your requirement. And along with this invitation, you would like to have some description. This is a test meeting for Google Workspace. Okay, and documents are attached. I can attach here the document. I can give a link to this. It's all fine. If you want to add a file, you can give here. Click here and add. Drag and drop the files from anywhere. It's fine. Just keep it adding. And that will say, for example, anything which is simple and easy one I'm trying to add. Okay, something is not there. Okay, I just added one file. See, I can add a file. Along with the meeting, before coming to the meeting, people should go through this. That is where it will be easy for them. That can be added. That way, whole calendar setup is done. When you click save, it will ask me, see, you are inviting somebody who is not part of my own college, but somebody else. If it is your own college email domain, then it will not ask this. Directly you can send. Just, I'm sending anyway to Amit, so don't worry, just ignore this email. Just click on send. See, it is saying that you are sending it to this specific email. Are you sure? It's okay, fine, I invite. What happens when I send this? Some of the documents are there with me. It is sharing with him. It's okay, send. Okay. Now, if you just see there, color is also there. Meeting time is there. Date is there. And it is generated with Meet link also. This is the link. This becomes more easy for you whenever you are scheduling, whenever you are organizing it. This can be done. This is a tool too, which will help you to understand our best communication starts with these two. We will have more things in our classrooms. What in this? Basically, we will have files, presentations, research file, your class file, note, video, audios. Sir, where will we keep in email and a calendar? Where it should go? The next part where it should go is your second part, or maybe the third tool, which is for storage purposes. It has got more options with you. That's why it is with us. Google number.
Dr. Vinay, I have a small question about the yes. calendar, if I may.
Yes, please.
Yeah, so what is happening is, because we have already started using it in our department, and now we realize that it would be nice to actually, I mean, like while I'm scheduling a class, I do it from the calendar, my Google's account calendar.
Yes.
And then I'll share it with the students.
Yes.
The Google Meet I'll share.
You just have to add their email address.
Yeah. I mean, like I also want to populate my departmental calendar. I mean, like how would my department know that I'm taking these classes, right? So is there any way?
Yes. You can have here, you can create one more new calendar here on this, which is available over here. These are all the calendars. For your department, if you would like to have one with only you people, I mean, only staff should know about that. You have an option on the top to create a calendar. You could see on the top here, create this, and it will allow you to name it also. This is a calendar. It is possible to create a schedule. Similarly, you will have your calendars. You could see this is for your scheduling and a specific one. If it is a calendars, you will have here plus to create your calendars. You can see here, create new calendar. And you can specify the department name here, and that you can share the calendar with your own colleagues. Then all of the colleagues can see that. For all of you, automatically it appears on the same screen. You don't need to do anything. You just have to share this. Say, for example, department 1, 2, 3, 4. This is one. You can describe this and you can create this. This is as a department calendar. It will be created, and it will also be a part of my calendar plus my department calendar, like this. I will try to show you one. There's too many things are there. Yeah, you could see here, it is created right now, whichever I used. If your calendar and plus this is ticked, that means it is enabled for you. This you can always ensure that you can have sharing with this other people is possible. We request that you share this with, once again, share this with your colleagues, then it will be easy. So that they can also use this much easily, faster. You can see, make available for your institute. It can be done, make available for public, or get a shareable link, you can do it. Just copy this and share it with your faculty members. If everyone clicks on this, automatically that calendar will be added in their calendars, and all of your department colleagues can see. One time only they have to do it, and every time you add it, it automatically comes. So everyone will know that at what time who is taking is easy. We do not want that should be added in your personal calendars. If you want to maintain a departmental level, keep a full department one calendar, individually separate calendars. Do not mix it. If you try to share it the other way, it may confuse. Sometimes at the same time, there are 2-3 faculties may be taking classes that may end up in a confusions. That's why we want everyone to get familiar with your calendars first before you go for a collaborative departmental calendars. So as a department, if you would like to do it, it's almost preferred that use a calendar, create new calendar and share it with your colleagues, and it is always possible and you can use. If you want a specific people, see, you have an option here. Share with specific people, you can add here. That's an advantage. Only this calendars, department only calendar, you always have option. Only department people, 5 people, 10 people of your department, please add them here. Click add, add their name and emails is done. And can they see all the events? Can they make the changes in the events? Can they make and manage and sharing? You can give a permissions what they can do in this. If, for example, HOD wants to create a calendar and he wants to share it with others, but no editing options, you can do it here. Or you would like to create one calendar where everyone can edit as a department, you will know it is possible. Now, advantage here, if you do this, all calendars will be visible in one screen for me. I don't have to shift my calendars. This look, what you see here is only one. It may be by different people. And see, this is yesterday was something like day before yesterday. See, Ramzan is Eid ul-Fitr. That's a holiday part, which is not my calendar actually. I never do that part. But it's an Indian holidays calendar will give me this option, something like this. See, you could see there are so many calendars here. As per those which are available for me, I can have. I can create as many calendars as possible. I can arrange it accordingly. With color-wise, I can do that. Each one can be different one, which is possible to make sure that. See, this is like purple. Anything which I add it on to this one, that will be added only on this. That way, it becomes more easy. So first is, use personal, get familiar. Second one, use one single calendar for the whole department is preferred. That way, you can utilize this. Hope that answers.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Next is where a lot of data will be generated now. So when you start using a Google Workspace, more and more data will come. Not only here, without this also in online digital platforms, when you shift into next mode of regular mode to another mode, more major requirement by everyone is that where will I keep my files? Where will I keep my reports? Sir, department is asking so many reports. Deanery level will ask so many reports. HOD will ask so many things. College will ask me so many. Administrative level will ask me. Admission office is asking me. But your own personally, there are class-wise reports are there. Student-wise report. Where will we keep all this? So best place to keep all that is Google Drive. How this works? For every email you got, you have linked with one Google Drive. around 100 TB of data, which will be across your institute directly stored, which will not even cross that much, and directly link to your emails as a group wise when it comes and gives to you easy for accessing. Basic advantages. What does this drive will do for you? This drive will help you to do the few things like you can store all your files irrespective of what types of the files you have with you. Sir, I have sound file, I have an audio file, I have a video file, I have a documents, I have a newspaper, I have photos, I have PPT, I have research paper. You name it, you can save it. It doesn't matter which type of the file it is. It can be saved here. One. It is just saving? No, it is accessible across the devices, across places. You just need to have internet connection. You use mobile phone or you use drive or you use a laptop or use a tab. You can access your file from anywhere in the world with just internet connection using your email address. That's where storing, accessing. Sir, after that, what we do? I store something, I can get it back. Something like our basket or a Godrej where we keep all our things and then we take back, like a bank locker, keep, take back. So you are the only one who have a key. You can do all that part. Second, you can share this. When you store and retrieve is possible, at the same time, you can also share the same file with somebody else without giving a full access. With giving full access, with collaborative work, you can do that. It's called a sharing and collaborating. Sharing is I can make you view my file. Collaborative is you and me together, we will work in the same file with the student, with the faculty, with department, with whomever you want, with email, you can do that. Additionally, that is a basic part of a Google Drive. Apart from that, you can also create files here itself, even though without having a software installed on our computers. Something like similar to our MS Office, whatever we have, Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Similar to that, Google Drive has something called as Cloud Apps. It runs on a cloud, that's why it's called Cloud Apps. What is these Cloud Apps? Similar to create any documents, you have a software called as Google Docs. For your Excel kind of a work, Google Sheets, spreadsheets in a Google Sheets. For creating PowerPoint slides like this, what I'm showing you, using Google Slides. Forms where you accept data from someone, and also you can have your own websites, which is easily possible for us to work with that. So Drive is actually helping us in multiple ways. Storing, accessing, sharing, collaborating, and also create something new is possible. How do we access this? Same way. Open your email, click on the nine dot box on the right side top. Then next is your drive. Just click once. This is one way to open. Sir, can we open like a calendar.google.com? Can we open directly the drive as well? Yes, you have to type drive.google.com. Fine. That will open and help you to open your drive. It will look like this. Now, if you use personal email, you may not get few options what you are seeing it right now, which may not be visible if you are using a personal email. I'm referring all the things, features only to institute level Gmail with collaborated workspace, whatever you have got, that email will give you all these options. On the left side, you could see the options first. There is something which is priority. Whichever is recently used by me will always show on top. Now, sir, is it necessary that whichever I have used recently will only appear here in priority? No. Along with me, if my file is shared with someone else, and if that person opened now, how do it knows that? See, both of have to work together. He may work anytime, I may work at any point of time. He works in morning, I works in the evening on the same document. But if they have used, if my friend or colleague has used it in today morning, that means he has used it. So it, when I open, it will say, you may require the same file. That's why it shows something like this. You can see that example as well here. On top, whatever these files are visible now, these are all the files which are opened and edited by me and whichever the file is shared with my colleague at the same time or maybe in advance. So it is guessing that. That's intelligently, it is trying to work and telling me, this is file, one of your file, one of your colleague has, Kirubanand sir, has opened it and you would like to open the same, yes or no. If yes, I'll click open. Otherwise, you just ignore it. Don't worry. Then another file, which is say that another lab marks, which is there here at all, CIA marks is here at all, internal marks is here. All that is opened by me. Recently, you have opened all this. Would you like to work on these files again today? If directly open, don't, sir, don't do anything. Just open, drag, click here and open, start working. That much easy, it does the work. If not, then all other things options will come. Not always that is useful. Many times it is useful, but sometimes we need other things. We are not creating anything. We are just looking at this. In the drive, you could see this is where my drive appears. These are all my folders. And that can be viewed here by clicking on drive. You can see on the right side, all these files will appear. Inside that also, there are quick access. Whichever is recently opened still will appears, and our most recent one will appear on this part. Just now see one conference open, tech talk was there which got opened, recorded video appears on me. It's most recent one, whichever is there. And down you could see all files and folders. And also you could see here, it is easy for us to colorize my documents as per my requirements, I can work. So it's more easy for me, sir, if it is color, I can understand all green is first year, all red is second year, all yellow is third year, all blue is my department one. Like that, you can colorize this and you can work with this. So I have accordingly colorized it and I'm using it and it is fine. Now, that is your drive. Your files and your folders will be inside this. Now, if somebody else has shared the file with you, all that will appear in this part called shared with me. This is where it shows. If somebody has created a file in the Google Drive, like me, somebody, my colleagues have created, they have shared it with me, then those folders will appear here. How do I know who has shared it? There is a column here which shows you who has shared it is available. There are all names will appear who has given me these files. I can open, I can work on this. Whenever they remove the permission, it will go off from here. It will not be available. Then recent one, whichever recently you have used, it will appear on this part. Most recent one compared to priority, it is normal one. And some of the files and folders, you can star this. Something like important, you mark it. All those star marked will be separate. This is always I want this. That files, I can make it like this. I have less used this, but it is good option which we can use it. It is available. Star means whenever you don't need to search, go, find, do double work. Click star, all star will come at the same time. It is easy. Whichever the file you are deleting it will be available in trash. Remember, trash is there for 30 days. Delete also will not go away from your systems. This is all advantages if you use your institute emails, not in the general emails. This will, general email also has but limitations in different way. Any file which is deleted from your folders of Google Drive will be available in the trash for 30 days. See, this got deleted on 20th. It will be available till May 30th. After that, automatic deletion is there. It can be. How much I'm using it right now? See, around my drive file itself is 356 GB. That much of data is there. Still, it works same speed, same fast, and same way of accessing it in all devices. And anywhere, anytime, any place, I can get this file. That way it works. I will show you one sample how it will work and how it can be created. Then you can get more advantages and more easy way to use, start using with this. I prefer always start using from the day with the folder name, organizing it easily. Semester 1, semester 2, semester 3, student wise, class wise, group wise, department wise, however you want it, create that. So most easy is in my drive, I'm clicking on a button called new. Right now, till now, what you saw was only to store some file and keep it with you. How do I keep it here, the file? This is already existing one. Now, first new one you wanted, all starts with this new. Oh, one by one, I'll show. Just click on new. You could see so many options are there, what and all you can do here. The first three is related to your files. Next few other options which are there below this Google Docs and all is related to your apps. That means cloud apps which we can use it. First, we'll see this example and then we'll go for that. Not much because it requires more time for us to explore more in the drive itself. This is where the folder. I'm creating one new folder. I'm just giving it as 000 because it should appear on top. Otherwise, it may not appear on top. That's why I'm just giving it an alphabetical order. New demo folder. It just created. It should appear on top somewhere here. Yes, you could see here. It has appeared here. New folder, I have created it. I'm just right-clicking on this so that I get more options here. I'm just changing the color so that it is visible to us. See, red color folder is visible. Now double click this to open it, and this folder is empty. There are ways to create a file. Sir, I don't have any files on this drive, but I have it in my desktop. Can I do it on this? I'll just show you. I will look at this one second. Okay, there is a file over here. Tell this file, just click drag and then put it over here. Bring it those files and you'll be able to drag in this. So from anywhere, bring the file here. Just drag and drop it on this empty space and leave. See there, it is getting uploaded here and it is done. 1, 2, 3. File is uploaded here. That much fast, easy, simple, and click and drag. 34 MB it got uploaded. See here, 34 MB file it is. How much time? It is hardly took 5 seconds. And that way it is cloud based and it is fine. So any file, sir, can we check one more file? One JPEG file is there, something. Okay, I'll just drag and drop here. This also takes something. See, look at the number of times, amount, other things at all. It's done, ready. 870 KB, but it's in 2 seconds, it is done. So these are all the files, which any files you can drag drop. Folder itself you can drag and drop, it is fine. Now this is the file which is available with you. If you want to see, you can double click and see that file, always it is available for you. Now first part is here. At any point of time, you can use any device to access this, fine. Select this, right click, always you have option to download this. Not only here, in any device. You go and sit in somebody's system, some other home, some other computer, some other mobile, fine. Go there. If you are able to log in, just click, right click, and then click on download, it works. So it means accessible anywhere, any place. Just drag, drop, save, folders, create, done. Sir, I would like to give this file to my friend or my students, my colleagues. I want to share along with. Share is, there are a lot of things are there in share. Share is just to view. Share is also possible to collaborate. Giving a full permission for them is possible. So there are multiple ways. One is clicking on the file, right click. There is an option called as share. When you click share, one small window opens and it will ask you to specify what you would like to give a permission or to whom you would like to give a permission. Specify that person. Say one person name appears, I'll give you. And I can write a message here that what, see, this is a sample video. He can be an editor. No, I don't want him to be an editor. I want him to be a viewer. He can just view. He can't do anything else. See, that means you have a full control on your file that your students can only view. They can't do anything. They can comment, they can give suggestions, but they can't do anything else. That is why different options are there. As a viewer, you can make them. As a commenter, you can make them. As an editor. Editor will be having an option of open it, edit it, download it, do modification, delete, all are possible. Viewer and commenter can't do all. Viewer can only view, commenter can even comment. See, view can also, files can see the comments, viewer, but commenter can comment on the file itself. So it is based on your requirements, you can do on this. No, sir, I don't want to risk. This is one way. Just click on send, an email goes to him, and in his Google Drive also, it will be available directly, it goes. That's one way. If not, no, sir, I don't want to give it to any specific person. I want to give it to everybody. Publicly, I would like to give it to all. Below, just come and click here, change your permissions. Click here and see. Restricted was the first option with only specific people. Or anybody inside your institute can access this file, second option. Third one, anybody with a link. If you share the link, then only. This is the link. You can copy this and give this link to anybody in the chat window, in the WhatsApp, in an email, in any other format. Only then they can view it. With the link, can they edit? Yes, that also option is available. So you just have to spend 2 minutes trying to understand that what is sharing, with what permissions, what I would like to give it. See, in urgency, if you do, you will give it an editing to somebody who don't want to edit, will always open, edit, delete will happen. Your students might do a lot of things. So first time when you're doing it, play around with this with your colleagues. That's always the best option, I will say. Once you know this is all available, play with your friends. It is easy for you to get familiar with this and you can do more things with this. Too many things are there, but apps, other things will come back. This is the easiest way. 3 things to remember. You can save any file. You can share with anybody. And you can also add a collaborator into this. We will see that how it works. So that's a basic arrangement to do with this. That's a part of your work inside your Google Drive. Too many are there, but I'm just showing a glimpse of all that so that you can start working with this easily. Then you can manage more. Next is your, what is next required for us? Sir, we have a Gmail, we have our calendar, we have a drive. So all the basic communication, organizing files are ready with us. You need to start maybe taking a class with them. You need to conduct your online things like others are conducting. You should be able to do this more. This you experiment with your family members, your colleagues, with your friends. You'll get more familiar with Meet much easily. What does this give? This is a video conferencing tool. Majorly available without downloading a software. This is the one easiest platform. You name any other software like Zoom or Microsoft Teams or WebEx. You name any of those, you have to download and you have to install and then you have to work. It's very rare to get working on a browser. But this is the one software which you need not download the software, but this software is available on the browser. Click and work. Right now, what I'm doing is the same one. You never downloaded a file, even on your phone means you have to download the app. If it is a computer system, it works in the browser window and it is easy to work. So video conferencing tool, which helps us up to 100 people can join on this. Please note, if it is more than 100, we are not in that category. First, you saw the four categories of the software workspace. We are in the fundamental, so up to 100 people it is allowing. And based on the server capability of your area, if nobody else is using it, it might allow a few more people to join and then work. But limitation is there with 100. Recording of the whole session is possible. You can be able to use the whiteboard option inside that. Later, I will show where it comes and all. Different layouts you can set. You have a hand raise options. So many other things are there coming up right now. So where people can hand raise and say that I have a doubt, I have a questions can come. You can lock it. Nobody else who have not invited to my class should not come. This, you would have seen that 1 year back, we had this problem in Zoom or in WebEx or anywhere. Most of them will. We create a class when we are conducting, somebody else comes to my class and then start disturbing. And that's called a Zoom bombing. So many things were started in the early days. And we are just doing our class, somebody else can come. So those things can be avoided very easily. You just send an invite to only your students and you have a control button in the Google Meet that control it, gone. Automatically it will be solved. So locking is possible. Mute everyone is possible. You can mute a specific as an administrator or as a owner of the invite or whoever is calling the invitation to the Google Meet can control all this. You can also present a screen, which I'm doing right now, is possible. Additionally, you get something called as turn on captions. Turn on caption is one, whichever the words I speak now will be automatically converted into English and it appears on the bottom. You can try if you are sitting on a system or on the mobile, you can just click on that turn on captions. It will show every word which I speak appears like a subtitle on the window. I can't show it right now because it's my own window and I'm talking over here. But if all of you, those who are present, attending the presentations, like your students who cannot understand sometimes the accent what we speak, mother tongue influence is always there with us. Sometimes we mix up Hindi, sometimes we mix up with Bangla, maybe sometimes with Tamil, Telugu. We may mix up with, don't use the words, but the accent will be forced, or influences will be there. Students may not understand much. So our English should be clear. This has got around 80 languages. Out of that, English is right now, and multiple languages are yet to come. Indian languages are yet to come, but as of right now, English is the one which gets translates immediately on the live, and bottom it appears with words. So it's an advantage when we start using with Google Meet. How do we start with this? There are multiple ways to do it. More easiest ways are there nowadays, which can be done on this. Now, if you go to your email, there are easy methods here itself on, 1 second. Okay, on the left side of your email, you could see that there is a meet. Below, there are two options. If you have created a meetings, you will get the list here. If you are creating a new one, just click one and it will start one new meeting here. See, as simple, go to email. That's why all resource or sources back to your email. That's why you should be more familiar with your email. Then click on new meeting here. One click and meeting is ready and it shows me a window. You could see here. Share your new meeting. Copy this and share with your friends over. Or you can send invite. Clicking on this, copy the full invite. You can click. You can do that. Or share via email. When you click this, an email composition will happen automatically and it will start helping me to type the email address and send it. I'll show you. Ready, see? Meet invite from Vinay. And whomever you are sending it, type their address here and send over. So you don't need to do all this. Copy automatically is done by that. This is a link also. It will be getting generated and that much fast. This is one way. First method, starting your meet using your email in the meet option on the left side below new meeting options. If it is my meetings, right now there are no meetings which I've created. If I've created it, see, this will be there, which are all created here available on this. This is what you should remember. Where will you search when there are so many meetings available? So many classes are there in my next week. How do I know? One is in calendar, you can have a look. Other one is here where you could see that new meeting in your My Meetings, all list will appear on this based on what are all available for today. And then day-wise, it will also show that what are all available. That's an easy way. One method. Second method number two, how to start your Google Meet is on the right side, 9 dot buttons. Scroll down, you get an option called Google Meet. It's a meet. Click that and it's another screen which opens and it is ready. You should be familiar with all types of windows which opens. All windows may not look similar, but options and requirements are same for us. Correct? That is where it is more necessary for us. Now, this is a window, another second method to open the same Google Meet. One was there, one is here, second one. There is another option here, you could see. See, 12:30 was today. I just made it here as a meeting which is going on right now. It automatically reminding me, which I'm right now. See, it's showing me now. Now the meeting is happening. That's why it is showing me that. Now, next one I'm just creating here called as new meeting. Create a meeting for later, maybe for tomorrow, maybe for day after tomorrow. Apart from calendar, you can create here. Clicking on this, it will ask me. So you just copy and you can just give it. You can start working. One, you want to start immediately, instant. That is also there. Third one, schedule in a Google Calendar. I always prefer, if you are doing an instant right now, sending it 1 minute, 2 minutes, within that you want to create it, still use Google Calendar, the most best option. Because whatever you discuss, whatever you chat, whatever you record will automatically appear in the Google Calendar for future reference. But if you don't do that, these things will not maintain that. If you're creating an instant or if you're working on that, options are there, but it may not save everything other than calendar. Always keep in mind, calendar is always good. Now here you see, enter a code or option. If somebody has sent you that nickname meetings, then you can do it. Otherwise, this is not necessary as of right now. Use calendar, and with your references, your class name, it can work easily. Then what else are other than this? What is the next method? One was inside email, clicking on the left side, one. Second one, clicking on this 9-dot buttons, clicking on this meet is the second one. Inside that, options are there, you can see. Or another one is there on directly in the address bar, just type meet.new. See that? Meet is the software. New is new meeting. Just meet.new, press enter. I'm not typed anything else. You're able to see that. Camera may not appear, but it will directly appears and shows me that my meeting is started. See? Again, this video, I'll try to stop it here so that it can come on the other windows. So this is available, I'm able to see, and my window is ready. There is turn on captions. Every word I speak here, you could see now the word appearing on the bottom, like closed caption. CC is closed captions, like film subtitle. It appears on the bottom of my screen, and it is available for all students who can just listen. And if there is an internet connection low, my video is not coming to them, you switch off your video and talk. If they will understand easily your words in subtitle way is one option. And on the other side, you have more things. This is right now using a different one as a join one. So I'm just showing you samples. On the right side, three dots, you'll get more options over here, which is useful. You can change a background, you can change the options. Then you will be able to do the layouts, how it will look like. See, if there are 48, up to 48 people can be in one single screen, which is possible. You can see 49. You can see the tiled one, which is possible. Up to 49 people, photos can appear on one single screen is possible, which we can do. After I stop presenting my screen, I will show those options, which will help you to understand. That way I can create. That means meet.new will help you to do directly. How it opens? Based on whichever email you have opened, on that email, the meet will link automatically and it goes. You can call somebody, copy this and give it to your friends and make them to attend. It's always possible. That way, this will help you to work with Google Meet. Too many things are there, but basic stuff you should understand. This will help you for your regular class when you are trying to do it. One, remember, communication with email, your scheduling, and then planning with for your class is with calendar using Google Works, Meet. Google Meet should be used. Then all files in the Google Drive. That way, your basic fundamental or maybe foundation level, you are ready to work with. Beyond this, there are more softwares. Maybe that's why I said, I will show you some things right now, but not all demos is possible because of the time availability. We will be able to have a glimpse now. Take some time, start using the email, work with all these, come out with list of doubts. We'll be able to clear that so that it will help you that, okay, this is what I use. This is the right method. This is what I did not understood. This is how I should solve it. That makes you familiar. Then you can transfer it to your students with more familiarity. Because we have to give a glimpse of this to you as well as students, then it will be more useful. There are docs which are available. This also is an app. This is where it is available. This is available as an app in your Google Drive itself. Where is your drive? Here. In the new, you would have seen that there are, these are all apps. docs, sheets, slides, forms, and many more are there. You could see here, drawing, map, slides, Collaborify map, Google Apps scripts, Google Collaboratory, laboratories are things can be done on this CodeLab, Jamboard, PRDeck. See, extra things also I've added, which is available for me. At least minimum basic, everyone will get, at least till here, this much, everyone will get. Creating file, creating folder, you can drag and drop folders, creating a doc, sheet, slide, forms, drawings, map, sites are all possible for everyone to get it, and it is useful. And in each one of this, you have two options. Already existing template, or you can create a new document and work. How does it look? Have a look, then you'll get all other apps are same. First one I'm using Google Docs with a blank document. What does this do here? You could see here, what does this Google Docs does? Why should we use this? Please remember, as a teacher, it is our responsibility to document everything, and we will write a lot of things, and we will share a lot of things. We will collaborate more, and we write our research paper notes, or maybe the class notes. Our students will also do the same thing. By adding images, by without that, with that, it's all fine. That is done in a software. Generally, people were doing early days with MS Word. Even now also people might do some of the work with MS Word. Similarly, this is also another documentation software, which is in a cloud, comes along with your Google Drive, free, and no download required, no installation is required. You can do all your work on online platform, something like this, where you could see, this is like a Word document, which is open here, and all these features are there. Cloud-based, no installation, write, edit, collaborate, start with existing template or your own new files. It works on mobile phone, it works on laptop, it works on PC, it works on anywhere, any place with any device which has internet, it works free. You have options to open a Word document and convert it to a docs and start working. Or already you're typing it here, saving it into a PDF is possible in two simplest way. I will just show you one, two glimpse. There are 100 features inside this. Two, I will show you, which will help you to do the sample work. So this is a document demo in Google Meet presentation. Wait, I'm just using Google Docs demo on Saturday, 15 May. Okay, this is what I have document. Like this, you can type a document and all similar features. No much difference, because that's why it's easy. MS Word, if I've used it, most of you would have used it. And it is familiar for all of us. That same option, same features are there. Two glimpses, I'll show you how best this software is. Clicking on the file. See, this is already, I'm not even pressing Control S. No save button is here. See, there is no save. There is no save. You can see there is no button called as save only. But sir, where is the file then? File is wherever you create, it will be in Drive. So give a name here. On the top, you give the name. This is Google Doc Demo 1 file number. Okay. And it is saved in the cloud. So I need not worry about this. You can start this file if required. Otherwise, just leave. Give the name is over. First option, see here. I can send this file as email directly to somebody after typing here. As a full letter, I can send one. And I can download this in any format which I like. Say directly as a document like MS Word, or directly as PDF. See how much we struggle to convert any document into PDF. Here, you just come type here, file save as PDF, one click. Downloaded. See, PDF file is ready. I will just show you here. You can see my file was downloaded, ready, saved, and ready to use. As simple as this, one click, you can get any file into PDF possible. That's one of the features. Second feature, which I like most, is another one called as voice input. Okay, there are so many. These two I'm showing you because you can understand how fast, how best this is. You can compare two documents, you can have a citations, you can write a bibliography, spelling and grammar, word counting, you have to write. Many, many, many features are there, which requires more time for us. But this can be easy one, voice typing. What does this do? This helps me in typing more faster than typing. That means voice input I will give, it will type for. Just switch on, voice typing will be given to the computers and it can start typing for me. On behalf of computer, this will type and help me in getting all my text, and it works. See how fast? How much fast I talk, this will type in the same speed, and it is accuracy is much better. I'm not claiming 100% always. If you're sitting in a quiet place and your accent is clear, it can type as fast as that. If it is that way, see, it's easy and simple way to type all our documents and make sure that our files are created with this research papers. No plagiarism, right? What is in your mind, you are just taking it and giving your students a much faster way to present, publish, write, submit the assignments is possible. That, see, if I type this, at least I need another 10 minutes to do that. But here spellings are auto-checked and it shows me sometimes grammatically if it is not right, wrong, and it will help me in doing and see students a much faster, see, and is there, right click, you'll also know, oh, not required, you can delete. Grammatically also it will suggest me and do. Sir, only English? So next question. A glimpse I'm showing you, that's why, see, 88 languages are there. Sir, Hindi possible? Or other languages, which Indian languages, see, starts here with, Nepali, Marathi, Hindi is possible, Gujarati. I'm not sure about the other languages which are required for us as of right now, maybe available. So I know few, I can just try it on this. Hindi, I will try to show. Will it work? Hindi will type, computer will help me to do it. Maybe I'll say a sentence, we'll try how it will work. Aaj hum log Google Docs ke baare mein seekh rahe hai. See this? How fast it will be, how cool is this, how fast and how best it will be if somebody who's presenting it. You have 88 languages to do the same job. You have, so a teacher job is to do the more productive work in thinking and do some research and present and teach better way rather than wasting our time in typing. We are not a typist. We are just the knowledge holders who can transfer our knowledge to students. You do your job. That's where this is more important to know this. You can save, you can highlight, you can do all works more easy, faster and better. That's why this is called as Google Docs. And collaboratively, you can do with the same people. Say here you can have option to share. If the Word document is shared with another person, say for example here this person, and I can add him as an editor, and that person can also type along with me together simultaneously. You can see here there is one red color, Tom is written. That means Tom is another person who is typing along with me. Like this cursor will appear, together we can type any number. If three students and one faculty can open the one single screen and share it each other, and the student can start typing and you can just observe who is doing what. Colleagues can do together work. So your syllabus, your departmental work, your meetings can be much faster now. All is saved. Where is this file, sir? Finally, where is the file? That's more important, right, for us. You have typed everything, saved here, given the name, but where is saved? In your, this one, if you see here, Google Drive, it's automatically saved here. Because I created the file from here. Open the folder, click new and create, it will be inside this folder. So file is always with me, saved. It is not in my computer, it is not in your computer, it is not in Google Meet. It is in the Google Drive, in the cloud space, in your attached to your email address. So that becomes easy for us. Similar to this, you have more apps. Since the time is not much, I can't show demo of all, but this is how it is. And this also has got a shortcut to open. One easy method was come to Drive, click on New, open the docs. Or if you have something like this, if you remember a doc.new, enter. Need to remember, no need to download, install. Just open the browser, type doc.new. Easy, done. It opened and ready to start saving your files works. How? There are three ways to do. Each one has got multiple ways. Doc.new, docs.new, documents.new. You type anything, it works the same way. Or you open the Google Drive and then open a docs, then also it is fine. You can work with that. This is the good features of docs, Google Docs. It can work. Page setup is there, comment. You can have a list of this. So many things are more, and we need to explore more and work with this. That is one of the app. Similarly, you have spreadsheet. Sir, I would like to work like an Excel file. Commerce people wants it, or other people who wants it. Like many people wants to work with data. Those people, like, you want to enter it and take it like that. Similar one, sheet.new, sheets.new, spreadsheet.new, any one of those, and it works with a similar way. But to just have a look, just look at this sheet.new. Can work, also opens an Excel kind of a sheet. That's why it's called spreadsheets. Ready, online, no downloads, all functionalities, all function programs, everything works similar. Give a name and start working. Nothing else is required. If it is not, simple method is always, I suggest before you go for all this, go to new, click on your Google Sheets, and then try to add files here and start using it. It goes inside your folder and it is safely secured. Lot of good features inside this. templates are readily available, new sheets you can create, explore options are there, and you can send it. There are so many other features which require some time to understand, but basically it works similar to an Excel file. All features are there and ready to publish on the web. That becomes more easy for us to work with these kind of software. Similarly, if you would like to create a PowerPoint presentations, see, we don't even call it as a presentations, right? Now we call it as PowerPoint presentations, because PowerPoint is a software which is so familiar or so famous that everyone starts using presentation means PowerPoint presentation. It's a PPT, slides, but in reality, it is just the slides. Slide can be created in any software. There are so many softwares out there, but we are familiar with PowerPoint. Similar to that, there is another software which Google gives free along with our Google Drive, is Google Slides. It has got plenty of options to do with this, and it works like this. You can open with slide.new, or you can go to your Google Drive, click on new, click on slides, and start new blank presentation. This is how it looks like. Same, if we are familiar with PowerPoint, we can do with this also. It's more advantage, it's online, it's always available. Anytime you can edit in computer, mobile, laptop, mobile also you can edit. You can use Google Meet in mobile and you can present the same file from the mobile is possible. That's an advantage when it comes. And it has got all features are similar, and more features are there here. Because it is cloud, it works much better compared to all other softwares. So more features are there here. You can explore this when you are creating it. Sir, I already have a PowerPoint presentation. Can I import all that into this? Of course, you can do that. In the file menu, click on import slides. Bring all your PPT files or PowerPoint files into this possible. You want to make a copy, you can download it. Even this can be downloaded as a PDF. It is JPEG as a photo, or you can publish it, print it. You name it, you can do it here is what the major advantages which provides with this slides. Similarly, we have a Google Forms where you want to collect the data from the user. Later, maybe you want to conduct a 1 marks, 2 marks questions for your online MCQs, multiple choice questions, true or false questions, and conducting a descriptive questions can also be done with this Google Form. Google Form works in two aspects. One, to collect the data as a research survey, you do it, it is possible. Second one, it can also be used as a quiz, like conducting an exam, conducting a quiz programs online using 1 mark question, true or false, multiple choice questions, drag and drop. Those can also be converted or can also be created using Google Forms. This is also form.new, or go to Google Drive, create new form is available. More features are there with this. Lot things are, it requires at least 2 days we need to understand what is Google Form. 1 day to just to glimpse and other things. So that's why first know what are all available, open at least once, have a look at that, what each one of these can do for us, get familiarity with the interface, click buttons where and all, then later you can explore more and come out with some of the doubts so that it will help us to solve and resolve and help you in using this in a better way. Similarly, drawing is available here itself. You can see in the Google Drive, clicking on new, then more, then there is a drawing. This is also an online software, cloud-based. See, all what is required for us in a daily life for a teacher is documentation, spreadsheets, slides, and then you also have something called as drawings. Sir, I don't have a software to do it. Can I draw it here? See, all shapes are available for you. You name it, what you wanted it. Check it here, it works. You wanted the shapes, see here. You name, it's fine. You can just draw it here and it works. And you can always have like this. Connect between these two using a connectors from here to here. Name it, use a text. You can order, draw, save, download JPEG file or PDF files, PDF, JPG, PNG, PSVG, any file ready to use. And you can directly copy from here. And also, you can use it on your docs. Generally, copy paste is what we try to do that, right? So, you don't need to do that. This, you just have to download this. Save it as, see, download it as a JPEG file and use that JPEG file into this. Inserting onto this is easy. So it is readily available. Upload from your computer from the downloads. So whatever I did there, it is available on this. Edit, use, faster, better. That's where this helps you to do this. So cloud-based collaborative tools, which is available, which can also be made available for easy editing options, and it works. And it is also built in with the Google Drive. For creating a website, we also have something called as Google Site. may not be required as of right now, but it is available. We will see sometimes if time permits and if you get an option, we will have a training on those parts. But important thing is there, which is most is Google Classrooms. I know time is moving a lot, but I've taken extra, but still I want to take another few minutes, maybe 5 minutes, to ensure that you know this part. This is very, very important. You have to ensure that your class goes on digital. Online classrooms, we do it. It is not just open a WebEx, open a Google Meet or just Zoom and then make a one online class and then you talk sometime for 1 hour and then you go, is not what we want. Beyond your regular meetings, like a live classrooms and non-live class. That's why a synchronous class, what we do is with Google Meet or WebEx or using Zoom is or Microsoft Teams, any software you use directly when you talk to your student is synchronous class. When you don't talk to them, but still you would like to have a class with different mechanism by doing all other works, which is what we call it as asynchronous class. That asynchronous class is possible with this called as Google Classrooms. Now, this is where it helps us in two ways. One, this as a application available inside the Google in the same email is enough for us to work on. Similarly, this is available as an app in our phone. Whatever I do it on computer, same I can do it on my mobile phones. So all facilities like chat, call, meet, collaborate, making a notes or maybe whiteboards, live classes and communicate with them is possible. Then share all your documents or your other things is all. Major is it is instant, it is paperless and it is easy. That is more, that's what everyone wants. If it is a tough, nobody wants to use it. As a teacher, first part for you is all other things what we discuss. You should be familiar with all that. Don't say that today you have learned and tomorrow morning you want to use this. No, we don't want like that. Today you have seen, learn it, experiment it, explore more, and then get familiarity and then start working it. This is one of those which are more required. How do we get into this? On your, any of those, whichever you have worked on, open email, any of the softwares, click on the 9-dot buttons, scroll down a little bit. All other softwares are there, which requires more time. Just scroll down, click on Classroom. What does this do? This is a online classroom platform. One second, this is not my email, other emails. Okay, this is a classroom platform. Now you can ask, earlier if it is an LMS, there is something called as learning management system, something called as different varieties of LMS are there, online virtual learning environment, LMS are there, ICT tools are there. Similarly, Google Classroom is also an another tool, which is mainly used for classroom communication and classroom management on the online platform between teachers and student. What does this do? It allows you as a teacher to create a classroom and create announcements, share it with your students, communicate with your students, accept the assignments, evaluate the assignments, give the grade and give it back to the students. All in one single place is here. Sir, if I have files in my Google Drive, you can access it here. That's the advantage. Remember, any files kept inside your Google Drive once will be accessible in all the tools which are available in Google. So it's easy, one time saving, but use it in every time, any number of times you can use all those. See, we are conducting right now one classes called the Indian Constitution for around 6,000 students. In the same platform, I'm using it. Intentionally, I divided into six boxes, or each box, what you see is called as classrooms. Each subject-wise classrooms are there. This is nowhere you need to, as a teacher, you don't need to depend on anybody else to do the work. As a teacher, you can do the your own classroom creation. You are the manager, you are the creator, you are the owner, you are the teacher, you organize, you control. So from all your side, you can take care right now. You don't need to call anybody. If your college has given you email ID, ready, start, go ahead and create your own classrooms. How? That's why sample I'm showing you how it will look like. One of my own class only I will try to show you right now. Where is that? I'm not sure whether this is how a classroom will look like. Inside that, there are four options with classwork. Don't worry what are all these options at all, but I'm just giving you a glimpse what this can do. On the left side, you could see, maybe bottom wise only I will try to see. All my news and events goes under this. I can make an announcement. My chapter one introduction is these topics, and each topic has got certain things. You could see. possible. Scroll down, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, and unit 5. There are some tasks which are given to them. There are few general information which are announced over here. It's all organized. Anybody ask, you just take a whole page printout and give them, this is how my class runs this time. Lab separately done. Then there are extra code labs which are given, lab tests which are conducted, 1, 2, 3, 4 tests. There are marks which are announced over here, repeat exams which are announced here, done. Any general information required, which is also there, they can have a look at this. For them, it is much easy. Communicating with them, how many are there? Just click on people and see which comes under this. So around 54 students are here, and these are all the people. See, that's how best, fast, and these are all the teachers. I have around 4 teachers in the same class. Along with me, co-teachers are there. So classroom is where it allows you to put more teachers, more students, and one click, you can call your students and come, and grades as well. At the end, you collect the assignments, and if they have submitted, how many not submitted, and what time they submitted, late submissions, full report is available, and it becomes more easy for us. So you don't need to write down anything on a paper. It's all maintained online. For example, you could see your lab. I will show you, and my student submits on this. Les would have submitted here. Just give me a second. It takes some time to load. There's too many things I've made opened on this. It may take some time. Just closing other windows. It's coming now. You could see a number here. 6 assigned who have not submitted yet, 48 people who have submitted out of that. That is very easy for us to know. Due was on March 29th. See, out of that, 48 people have submitted, 6 have not submitted. And this one, how many submitted, how many not? 46, 8 not submitted. We will know. And who are those? I can find out easy. Clicking on that list will also appear. That's why comfortability is there when we start using this in more way. We need another 2 days for this also, classroom to understand, maybe 1 hour each. It will give you very good, easy, step-by-step, all other options. That way, I'm just showing you that these are all possible. All this available on the single screen with one simple place. Say, for example, here, if I show you, all people have submitted out here and files are available. I can read here, I can give them the grade, and also I can evaluate it in the single place. That's how fast, easy. Who can give you so much of facility in one single place? You need to have your files, return documents, a number of students and their marks, and then returning them. No need of all those things at all. This way will help you to ensure that grading, collecting, assigning, returning, maintaining your own report is all possible. See, when they have submitted here, you can see on top, they have turned in but done little late. That time has been. How much time late? You can see here. 1 o'clock was the time, 1:34 they have submitted. It means time they have taken more on this. What they have done, I have given some assignments like a mobile applications to create an app for students. This is what they are supposed to do it. You can see their work. If it is all satisfied by you, okay, work is good, they have written something, documents are written, if everything is fine, below you can see here something called as grading. Out of 30 marks, give some marks here and click the return button on top. So that marks goes to the student. Like this, you do it for every student on the system. You can do the same thing on your mobile. Anywhere you want to do it, it's all in one place. That means your classroom is right now in one place. You want to share anything like, see, you want to have, give here, see, what and all things you can do here. This may not appear. This is an additional one I have installed here, how do, but remaining all will appear. You can post something like material, resources, study materials, question, ask 1 or 2 questions, quiz assignment, ask more number of questions in collaboration with Google Form. Assignment, give some question, ask them to submit it, and you give them marks. Based on arrangements you want, all can be done in one single place. Your all files is automatically saved in Google Drive folder. You don't need to create a folder for this. You create a Google Classroom, automatically everything will be in Google Class folder. Automatically, one new calendar will be created for this classroom. And you will also have a Google Meet links, which you can communicate with your students. See, all that we saw individually, plus together in one collaborated way in a classroom, they are providing us. That is making us a most powerful work. In mobile, app, or online, you can do this. On any device, it doesn't matter which device you are using, whether it is a Linux based system or whether it is a Mac OS or a Windows PC, it works. We use officially with our universities. You want to use it, you use your official, your institute one. It always helps you to do this kind of works. Now, meanwhile, knowing all these are important, right? You might have seen every day you type, you prepare documents. Google Docs are important. Similarly, Google Sheets, Slide, Forms, and Sites. What I'm giving you is one, maybe taking one more minute, last minute, to give you a glimpse of all these you can learn by yourself. Not extra training required. But how do we do that? There is one link here and a QR code. You can take a print screen, you can take a photo, you can save this. This is the link. Free of cost, 8-week program given by Google for education, Google for Workspace program. This is available for all of us. Scan this, click this, register yourself now, and automatically every week one email will come to you with one small short video and few descriptions about each software. 8 softwares you will learn: Google Drive, Docs, Classroom, Form, Slide, Sheets, Sites, and Drawing. Whatever I specified now is all made available from the Google only. Directly we are getting it and we are giving it to you so that you can learn. This does not end here. This is just the beginning. Journey begins now. Lot more is there. That's why I say always this is just the glimpse. Beyond this, you can learn all this in much better way, and then you can become proficient in your own way. This is not your subjects. I know that some of you may think, I'm from a commerce, I'm from a arts, I'm from a sociology, I'm from a science, biology, botany, or maybe maths. Why should I learn all this? Irrespective of your subjects, these tools will definitely help you to improve your education, not only your subject. That's where the first slide I said, even what Sundar Pichai said, it is not to like a drastic change in one day it will change. No, when you start using tools, it will help you to definitely change the way we communicate, change the way we organize the data, change the way we give it to our students will definitely help us. That is the reason why we are trying to give you this glimpse. You can save it, register. I prefer that all of you register yourself so that it comes to your email automatically, give your official email, and at least for that purpose, you'll be able to check. You can add official email to your phone, adding an account Google, you can use this. So preferably have your 2 accounts, one personal and one this, in the phone itself, so that your email can be checked every time automatically when it comes. So easy way to notify yourself and can work with this. If you have any questions, please do ask me. We'll be able to take after my stop, my presentation sharing, I can answer for all of these things. And at the same time, I would like to show that for all teachers that where will I get all these? How did I get all these information? How I am doing it all these to this one is through this. You can contact me at any point of time. My email is there. My phone number is there. I'm also on social medias like LinkedIn or Twitter or on Instagram or on Wakelet. You can call me anywhere. On the right side, what these badges which are shown here is all Google conducts even at training programs. That's why we became a trainers to train the faculties. Maybe some of you could also try it. Maybe after you explore with this, basically, you can also try it to become a certified educator. That's an international official recognition given by Google. So that some of you, at least I need, some of you should, everyone is good, but at least for some of you, can start training, become a trainer on your own campus, then you can become an educator and then certified trainer. First thing, it is not easy. It is fine. You need to spend some good quality time of learning, and then become explore, and then only you can become an educator. Educator is the one who trains students as well as your colleagues. You would like to train outside your campus to somebody else, you need to become an official Google certified trainer. That's also another level. The 4 levels are there: certified educator level 1 and 2, and then certified Google Cloud, certified G Suite, and then you become a trainer. So I've tried to that level, then only I'm trying all, they officially recognize and ask me to train across people in India. And as of right now, there are 7 people. Out of that, in South India, I'm only taking care below, I think, Uttar Pradesh. Delhi, there are 2 people. And one more is not active as of now. I'm the only one who's taking care in South India to train and give you up. So I'll be always happy to give and do this work. And this is one part of this. Beyond the Google also, there are so many other tools out there which you can use it in your class. But always, I prefer that. Start with which is available. Good that your institute has taken a good initiative, and I appreciate their effortness to bring it everything onto your campus right now, and it's ready now to use it. Student details will also be ready to work with along with your emails. You can start working and utilizing. This is the overall glimpse of what a Google Workspace is available as of now, which you can also take it. Start opening it, practice it. As and when it requires, please do let us know. Sometime definitely we need to have one more session where we will be able to work something like clarification or requirements, we will be happy. I'll be happy to do that part from my side. Hope it was useful, and you had some at least getting some glimpse of what exactly your institute has initiated, and what are all the things you are getting from that, and where we need to start. Right? Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Vinay. I mean, we very much appreciate this overall presentation, the detail, idea about everything that we are going through. So I think this transition will actually take a few days or months, actually, for everyone to get acquainted with the new devices, the apps. But I think we still have a few minutes left. If anybody has any question, then I think, we can still take that. Yes, could you please, Sudip sir, just go ahead.
Good afternoon. This is Jamshed Ahmed from Department of Urdu.
Hello, may I ask?
Sir, I'm Jamshed Ahmed from Department of Urdu.
Yes, sir, please.
Just I want to take a question. Sir, Google Drive को जो है मैंने use किया था, कुछ documents save किए थे उसमें पहले. तो before 4-5 months I got one mail के this is for limited period. You save your all the documents, otherwise it will be deleted. So there is something problem ke it will allow for some limited period or for lifetime you can save the documents there.
No. See, there are two ways in which the Google Drive works. If you are using your personal email,
yes,
then you will get a limited space, 15 GB of space in your personal email in Google Drive.
Okay.
If you are using an institute, whatever the now institute has given you an email ID, if you use that one, and it will be permanently saved in your Google Drive. And from the Google Drive, if you delete, it will be available for 30 days in the trash, okay, in the dustbin. And from there also you can take back. After 30 days in the dustbin, it is not available. But if you regular, normal way, if you are saving a file, it will be available for a lifetime. So until you delete, it will not be removed from anybody else. So you are the owner, you are the controller, it will be always available.
Okay, thank you. Sir, one more question, just
yes.
Because I told earlier that I am from Department of Urdu, then it was very interesting for me. And Google, you told about Google Docs, and particularly about voice typing. So just I want to know, there is option for Urdu. I can speak and it
Yes, it is there. 88 languages, which includes Hindi, Urdu, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Assami, Nepali. I think 11 Indian languages are available.
Very good, sir. And in Google Slide, if I want to make slide in Urdu, it is possible there?
No. What you can do is you type it in the Google Docs. You can copy and paste it to slides directly from there. It works.
Okay. Thanks.
Yes, Subodhi sir, you had a question.
Yeah. I have a basic question. First of all, thank you so much for this excellent delivery, and I really admit that it would enhance our capacity to reach out to the students. I have a very basic question. We have been taking classes through Google Classroom, Google Meet and WhatsApp at the same time, because you know that students are not always reachable. Because the entire system has to be pro student. It is not about us, it is about the students after all. So one basic thing, would you please repeat that part of your lecture? Suppose I have 100 students in a class. So I have to create one particular, suppose this is first year honors class, okay, first sem honors class. It has 112 students or so. So I have to create a common email ID, isn't it, for the entire class?
Yes.
And that has to be shared with all students along with the passwords.
No, you don't need to do that. What you should do is you should have only the list of students email ID only you should have. No username, no password, nothing is required for anybody.
Okay, so students personal email IDs are required, isn't
it? If your class has got 60 students, if your class has got 80 students, if your class has got 100 students, first time you should have 100 email IDs with you.
100, they are personal email IDs. Okay, I got
not personal email ID. They are official email ID only.
So the official email IDs are to be created.
Yes, we will give you all that college once. That's why we gave you all these trainings. For all staff, it is ready. For student also, all email IDs will be ready. And we will share that all with all the faculty members. They will know that for your class, your list will be ready with you. Only that email ID you should use and you should send them.
Okay, that is why I was a bit confused. That the students' official email IDs in this particular platform has to be get ready.
Yes, see, it is ready. It is ready. We have not shared with all of you, but we will share it definitely. One thing you should remember that once we start using the Google Workspace, there is nothing called as personal email.
And those personal email IDs are to be communicated to the students.
We will inform all the students that this is the details, this is what you can access, and we will give, if possible, we will try to give an orientation to them also, maybe half an hour to 45 minutes to all students, so that they will also get tips of what is it. Suddenly, if you go and tell them that tomorrow there is something here, you just use, they may not understand. So it is our duty to prepare them as well, maybe half an hour glimpse for them that this is all that's available, you can start using it. They don't need, but still, they are smart enough to understand, but it is our duty to do that. They will also be able to understand and use it. We will do that part. You need not worry. So that you can start using it.
Then classroom part of this entire process would start only when the registered students get their official email IDs, individual email IDs, and
yes,
by those individual
that and all
email
will
IDs, they will
be
able to connect.
Yes, that and all will be done from the administrator side. That student, reaching to student will be done. You, meanwhile, you can get to know all these practice and get ready. When the students are ready by another few days, you can start using it immediately.
Okay, fine.
Yes, surely, Dr. Bina, if I may. So currently where we are standing, actually, let me just give you an idea. I mean, we have created the Google Workspace under the college's domain. So everything is under the college's domain.
Yep.
And all of the faculty members have been, and all staff members have been shared with their email address in the college domain. So it's not the like @gmail.com thing.
No,
it's
no.
The
college domain.org.
Exactly. So I'd request everyone to actually go ahead and at least log in for once, check everything what you have, and get a feel of this. If you have any problems, any complications, anything that we also need to learn from you, then maybe we can work through that during this process of transition. Now, the second step as we're going ahead right this moment is like from the experts like Dr. Vinay and all that. I mean, we will be trying to train as much as possible to all staff members and definitely start including the students. So the next step would be, we have already created the departmental email address, which is the departmental group. So if you see, like, I can send email all my physics faculty members by just physics bccollege@aca.in. So that goes to all the faculty members. I have just created a, like as Dr. Vinay just mentioned, like I created a like departmental calendar, and I have started putting in my class schedule on that departmental calendar so that all my colleagues can see exactly when I'm taking the classes. Whereas at the same time, we will request you to maintain the records as we will be needing it later. And for Subhadipta, I think like what you mentioned is very correct. Like, but for now, you can use your Google account, your classroom, and you can share the link for the students that they can use their personal account for now, and they can just join. I mean, like, there is no problem joining. And that's what we're doing now. And allow us a week time or so that we can include all the students categorically. I mean, like, we will include them subject-wise, semester-wise, so that it becomes very easy for the college, for the department, for head of the departments, administrators, and teachers to communicate with them in single click. That's the whole idea of it. And I'll just remind one last time, that is, like, as you go through this transition, please remember the usage of this email account, cloud space, collaboration tools need to be followed with the strict guidelines, the privacy policy of the institute. It cannot be considered as a personal one. So if you have any problems and complications during this transition, please feel free to ask me, or Dr. Vinay is also reachable. We'll have other like team members also helping you during this process. Just let us know if you have any problems.
Okay, thank you, Amit. And
yeah,
this is really good. This is really good. Yes, we will of course start to use this as much as possible. And I must add one thing, that as now we have an institutional email ID, we would now be able to create an account on such platforms like ResearchGate, because they don't tell
us. That's where, if once you get this your institute email ID, there's a lot more advantage. We have just showing you a trailer of what exactly you can start with. After, once you start with this, the real picture starts. You will get more advantages to access more resources, more research articles in many platforms, many cases. As a faculty, you get, as an educator, you'll get more options, more free options to come.
Right. Yeah.
Thank
so
you,
I think, I mean, like, we'd like to stick to the timing, and I think it's pretty much in the end. If you have any quick question, we can still take it. If not, then I think let us thank Dr. Vinay. I mean, like, we really appreciate your total effort, the guidance we needed to actually go through this kind of a transition. And we very much appreciate if you can, like, allow us some more time for some more training sessions. Maybe we'll need some of your guidance in the future.
No, it will not happen in a one day. But right. Still, if you remember that, at the beginning, I said this is important. When you take some time, it is fine, no problem. Take a week time, 10 days, but transition is important. Once you do, you will enjoy the fruit after some time. That's where everybody should collaboratively work together, and the situations will definitely not be good at the outset. So our classroom should get shift into these things. In the long run, definitely this will help you.
Right. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Vinay. And thank you, everyone, for this time and your cooperation to actually go through this transition. And we'll keep you updated time to time. Just let us know if you feel any problem, maybe in the group. Call us, any of us, like, find there is some complication during logging in the process or using these tools, and we'll be in touch. So I think I'll end this meeting today. Thank you again. Yeah, you people, please do take care of yourselves.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.